Hello and welcome to this short educational video using Toad for Oracle DB admin module, 8 ways to increase your database power and flexibility. In this short video, I will discuss the 8 ways to increase your database power and flexibility by monitoring and optimizing the database, gain visibility into your database, quickly compare and deploy changes from test to production, production back to test, easily diagnose issues, analyze all your database objects, simplify database or data management, streamline change management, and get real-time alerts. Let's jump to the live demo. Okay, I have Toad for Oracle with the DB admin module. This is Toad for Oracle Expert, and I have the license for the DB admin module here. And we'll start off with optimize and monitor and optimize. From there, I would use database monitor, and the database monitor is very nice. And then the database browser. We're going to look at these two. So the database monitor comes up, gives me quick information on all these areas here on the left here. It'll paint in here shortly. It gives me alerts on things that probably need my attention quickly. This is a rather idle database, so not a lot of alerts probably going to pop up here for us today. And then the other one would be the database browser, monitor, and database browser. And that comes up. And between these two, we can see a variety of information. So the monitor maybe indicates what's wrong. The database browser allows me to drop into things such as table spaces here. And the alert is we're about to run out of space in a table space. We can easily see our percent used, add space, just click on the database and right mouse click. Double click on it, that's what it is. And brings us in, and we can edit, and alter data file, add more space if we need to. But we can see a lot of stuff that's going on at the table space level, at any of these levels, using the database monitor. Okay, to gain visibility into the database, I already ran the database health check. This takes a few minutes to run. I didn't want to waste your time in this short video. But it goes through all of these 120 different health checks, okay? Monitoring the alert log. We're going to take a look at the alert viewer here in a moment, but watch for Oracle errors, different kinds of Oracle errors, trace files, and the like. Most importantly, we're going to talk about analyzing your objects. Again, this health check, we'll take a look at what tables, indexes, partitions, and the like, that have not been analyzed. This is key. This differences since the last run, okay, will tell you all of the differences. Anything new that comes up between the last time you run it, like those alerts, those Oracle errors, and that alert log will pop up in here. Then you can go into the alert viewer. These pieces all blend together and work closely together with one another, okay? And this, of course, can all be emailed to you as well. So the next spot is quickly compare and deploy, and it's database, compare, and here we can compare data, we can compare schemas, databases, we can look for duplicates, we can compare schemas, okay, and we can get right down to the single objects, okay. This not only will do the compare, but it will build us a script that we can turn around and run, but it will build a script that will sync one with the other, and you tell it which way you want to synchronize to. So this would be very helpful at not only identifying the changes from test to production, but helping you install them without error and getting everything right the first time. Okay, easily diagnose, we would look at the alert log, okay? So maybe in our health check, some alerts have shown up perhaps. We can go into the database, diagnose, and there's the alert log viewer, okay? And this thing is major cool as well. Let's go ahead and run it, and it's gonna come up and populate this with, and we can tell when the database has started and all these different types of things, and background processes started and like. More importantly, we can sort. This is Microsoft Foundation, so we can sort by these headers. So we can drop right in here and then roll down and see if we have any alerts and when they happened and what they're about very easily. So easy to diagnose. Okay, we saw in the health check again about analyzing your objects, okay? Having objects that were not analyzed. Again, using Toad database monitor or database admin module, very easy to do the analyze management. So it's database, optimize, analyze objects, okay? So we go into this, and again, very easy to use. We can see, and this is across the system, but we can change the tables, for example. Let's go ahead and load my tables by a particular user. What did that health check tell us needed analyzing? We can go pick those and make sure that those get analyzed. But our production system, our application schema owners, you can do the whole thing. You can manage it very well. And once you run the, let's go in here and pick our student environment and say okay. And it brings up, there's my amp and dep table, and we can see when it was last analyzed and what's going on there. The other thing that we can do is, in a test environment, we can edit these stats, manually edit the stats and change them to whatever we want to fake the optimizer, cost-based optimizer out to make explain plans that might be advantageous to whatever it is we're trying to test, okay? To simplify database management, that's be the export and import features. So it's database, export. We've got database, data pump export. We can export to table as a flat file. We can, brings up a wizard we walk through. So we can export data, set it up for the SQL loader. Okay, and the SQL loader direct path option. So it's very fast, type load time, does all the work for you, does all the syntax. Likewise on the import side, we have a wizard to do that for us too. We can import just the table data, but we can import a variety of things using data pump import. And then there's our data pump job manager. So we can see how our imports went, if there were any issues and the like. Okay, change management. We want to make our export generate database script, generate schema script. These will generate all of the DDL for whatever we point this at. We can pick a particular schema. We can drop in here and take a quick look at this. And I want to change. I want to add a schema. I want to add the student schema. I'll go ahead and find it here real quick. And double click on that. And I want to add, I want to take this one out. Take this one out. Yes. Oh, and next. And these are all the different types of things that I can generate DDL for in a single script. So again, very easy to promote changes from test to production, test to development, test to a QA type environment, and make sure that you get everything right the first time. And then the very last thing in our eight ways is real-time alerts. Okay, so that would be database, monitor, and it is the database probe. Okay, this allows you to see all kinds of alerts that are going on in your database. Any kind of warning you might have, you can just hover over it and it's going to tell you what the problem might be. And you can add your own alerts to this. Okay, so those are the eight ways to increase your database power. Did the live demo. Eight ways. The Toad for Oracle DB Admin module, rich with features that assist the DBA in maintaining database stability by being able to quickly identify and solve issues. It also allows you to quickly and easily adjust important settings in the database, configure and manage changes to schemas, and even monitor vital areas, including alert logs. Okay, check out the Quest Toad for Oracle data sheet, Toad for Oracle DB Admin module. Check out my blog, my related blog posts in this series. The database health check goes into a lot more detail than what I went into here. And also check out the related blog post or Toad for Oracle 6 benefits for maintaining database health and stability. Shameless plug for my book. I am a regular on Toad World. I do have data point training available, and I use Toad often in my training courses. And I want to thank you for your time today on this short educational video.